Hey there, folks. This is DMC Jedi Man Gaming, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play LEGO Indiana Jones, The Original Adventures. This video, you can see I'm attired a little different than the first video, and that is because earlier today, I actually was at a local resale shop called Battery Street Jeans, run by the awesome proprietor, Stu. And they actually had this awesome leather jacket there for only $15. And as I can show you from the one I was wearing to begin with, it's just a fairly cheap fabric one. Has the Indiana Jones logo on it. So obviously this one that I'm rocking now looks a lot more faithful to what Indy would have worn in the film. So I thought that it would look a little better, you know, to wear that. But it's been a little bit since, it's been a long time since I recorded the first episode of this. You know, the first episode I recorded way, way back. You know, I just recently uploaded it, so that's also why my facial features have changed a bit, you know, in terms of less or more hair than I had at the time. But let's get this started. I shouldn't start the recording yet. I just realized that I should wait for us to get to Barnett College, you know, back to where we were before starting the next level. I'll start the recording then. Since you've already seen the opening, you know, titles and whatnot. So how's everyone doing today? Just want to plug Battery Street Jeans one more time, since, you know, they carry a lot of awesome merchandise there. As I said, Stu and the other folks that work there are really cool folks. So if you get a chance, you know, and you live in the Vermont area, obviously, you should check them out. I think you'll find some pretty cool treasures that you'll want to pick up. Okay, so we're going to probably load in the Barnett College here. Yep. Okay, now let's get this recording started. Starting the recording right now. Okay, this is the episode Anyone wondering that little bit with the hearts, that's because in the actual movie, the character actually has the words love me written on her eye. Pretty neat little thing, you know, might have missed it when watching. Double audio. I just remembered I didn't mute the television. So now that that's muted, the audio for the game will only be coming from here. Okay. So I want to go around and destroy everything I can first, because once I do a certain something, I won't be able to, well, throw the enemy. Unfortunately, it's been so long, I don't recall exactly what it is that causes the enemies to start pouring in. Sometimes, in at least a lot of current LEGO games, they hide things up there. I know once the machine gun guy gets in here, it's gonna be a little bit of a frustrating. Not frustrating. It'll be a lot easier for me to not have what I need. In case you're wondering why I don't just grab that little thing, because this has some barrels that show up, and well, I got this one at least uncovered. Okay, there's the barrels I was going to. Okay, so I guess I can grab that, that treasure here. Back to Indy, because I'm going to need to do some fighting here. We need to end some. And yes, I know that. Thank you. I'm trying to figure where the hell we go. Now the place starts to burn. And we have the machine gun asshole. Got him. Ah, and he just gave himself a hot fight. I'm your goddamn partner! Correctly, those Sherpa guys will keep spawning. Yep. That's what I need to bring over to there. Okay, that's a wrench, which allows me to repair broken items. Now, mechanics carry them on themselves. I knew there were more of them showing up. I figured it didn't make sense to grab this and make myself vulnerable and kill life. But yeah, what I was going to say is there are lots of things hidden in these games. Oh, well, that's not what I mean, there are, but the big thing in this is that your character can pick up items that other characters use. Okay. And what I mean by that is the wrench I just picked up, normally the ones that have the repairing skill is the mechanic. But if Indy picks up a wrench, he can then repair things. And I guess we get to build the third snowman. Do you want to build a snowman? And there we go, true adventure! Now, if we had a small character, we could go through that hatch for what would be presumably another one of the things there. Andy, but considering what you did, you deserve that. Yeah, for anyone wondering what Indy may have done, he had an affair with Mary, and she was There we go. Shit. Hey, look! It's Luke Skywalker! Now, I forget how I'm supposed to get that, but I think there's a character that's capable of melting some of that ice. Like with a flamethrower or something. Okay, I can go out. That's good, because maybe there's a torch or something. Oh, hey, a shovel! I wonder how far back we can go. I know I saw a dig spot way towards the beginning. But if we can make it all the way back there, then we might just be able to get that item, even though we're not really supposed to yet. Yes, we can make it back there. And the fact that we're able to go like this is probably, grab the, thing, the torch that we can come with you. Now, if we had, costume. Okay. I think this is going to give us a snowmobile, which we can then ride for a pony. And somehow I managed to get Marion back. And yes, I hear a new Okay. Unfortunately, it went down. And I do not believe there's one here. Okay, well, I already know it's not going to last from there to here, so no sense in grabbing that torch. We just have to hope there's another torch here. We also have to hope that the shovel respawns, because otherwise I may have to go back to that. Good, the shovel does respawn. Unseeable crevasse there. Okay. Okay, and that lowers that to where I can now jump to. This part here could be frustrating. Sometimes characters do not do what you want them to. Luckily for us, this one did. There are torches there. That's good. Shit. Missed the if I can get out here in enough time. Well, unfortunately, that did not have the effect I wanted on that. And I don't think it'll break the other thing, so I'm not going to go back and try. Like, I think, if I remember right, either I have to use a character who has some sort of fire ability, or I have to use one of the screaming characters like Willie Scott, or I have to use a bazooka. Also, this thing, if I had a scholar, or if I had a book I'd found, I could use the hieroglyphs to open something. This is the last section of this level. Go back and try the bazooka. Hmm. Purple studs are the most valuable studs in Lego games, by the way. Anytime you see a purple stud, you need to try and get it. Okay. How the hell did I get it? Oh, right. We have one shot with this right now. Like I said, I want to try it. And that did it! We lost, we got loot! And the mini tippies. Now, a fun little fact. Oh shit, I didn't realize I still had the bazooka. So, a fun little fact about this game, there are 5 Star Wars characters hidden in different levels. And if you find all 5, then you have the option to purchase Han Solo to play as. Which is a nice little nod to the original LEGO Star Wars 2, the original trilogy, where if you watch the LEGO Indiana Jones trailer, you would then gain access to Indiana Jones to play. Okay, now we have this again. Something I'm just going to help myself, because I know what comes if I don't do that. If I built the bridge, then a bunch of enemy soldiers would have started pouring out of it. So it's always best to destroy the truck first. Shit! Indy, why'd you get in my way? And now I gotta go buy, or not buy, I gotta go grab that again. I'd rather make sure that the cap is full too before I do that. But, oh. Shit! I still did pretty good, I think. So, at that level completed, I believe. I don't remember there being any. At least not that we can do in story mode. Obviously, if we come back and replay, there's a lot that we can get. Well, we unlocked Marion. Or rather, we got Marion. There are characters that we unlocked that we have to run first. We got two adventurers. We found Luke Skywalker. And I want to say we got five or six of the minikit pieces. Possibly got enough where I'll be able to tell you what the artifact is. A pyramid. It's a pyramid. And we got six. We're going to go back to Barnett College, and this is where we're going to end this episode of Let's Play Lego Indiana Jones, the original adventure. But yeah, we've gotten two of six levels for Raiders done. In case you're wondering, that red box, those are the red bricks for the series. They're basically parcels. You have to find them and put them in a mailbox, and then you still have to purchase them. But I'm going to end the recording right here. And that is going to be all she wrote for Let's Play Lego Indiana Jones Episode 2. I hope you all join me for episode 3. I mean, I hope you enjoy my videos. Anyway, this has been DMC Jedi Man Gaming, and I'm signing out. Peace, everybody.